settled by himself.
No, he actually did come to one of your shows. Yeah.
Is better, or
you can stand up.
Oh. Okay. Thanks. Nice. The short joke, which is out of the way. Just a couple questions for you, and some of them kind of been asked, but so CMA award winners, besides the Chris Stapleton, what were your thoughts about this year?
I loved them all. I don't think there were any surprises for me. Florida Georgia Line, of course. Chris was the big, surprise. I think Girl Crush had it from day one, especially with the controversy, then just added fuel to the fire.
Exactly.
Because once you crest one of those, then you can ride the wave the whole way. And what a great song they can do it with, too. I thought they were very humble. Loved their accepted speeches. I loved the writers' speeches of it as well. And then, of course, female Miranda, they said it was like the sixth time. So I think the big shock of the night was Stapleton.
Yeah.
I did. And again, man, the most talented guy won that for sure. No offense to all he was up against.
Yeah. So for the fans that have not seen you in 18 years or tonight are seeing you for the first time, what could you tell them what can they expect tonight?
Well, I'm hoping they expect fun. That's what I hope they're coming here to do, just fun and love one another. What I like about it is it's set up like no other show I've ever done.
Oh, by the way,
Patricia's in the middle. She doesn't start. So there's a time when you just get to be rhythm guitar guy, and as you're sitting there playing, you now get to see, because all the lights are somewhere else, they're not here where you can't see them. Now you see the faces, right? And I swear to God, people think they're the only person in the building because they got their eyes closed,
okay, well,
they're sitting there, arms are flailing like this, and they don't care.
So you saw me.
It's fantastic. That's what I love to see, because if I get to see that, I don't care about heaven.
Yeah, of course. We know your wife Trisha can cook, so what do you love she makes? Your biggest request?
She's fantastic. She, Vicki Hampton's birthday is this week, one of the background singers. And her favorite thing is key lime cake. She made it last night in the whole house. Smell of key lime. And it was fantastic. And then she has this cream cheese icing on it. Sorry, my mouth is watering. And,
that sounds delicious.
It's fantastic. But anything she touches is that way, I think, because she truly does love to cook. She'll come home from filming, and she starts cooking. And I think it's something that brings her joy and some kind of relaxation. Unfortunately for me, it puts me at about 300 pounds.
We'll keep that a secret.
Yes.
And how do you think country music has really changed in the last decade?
It's changed a lot in the last decade, but it changed a lot from the last decade before that and before that. And what it is all these kids, like Garth Brooks in the 90s, and they're coming up, they've got this thing that they love, and it's usually something they found in country music. So it's George Strait, Haggard and Jones. But oh, wait a minute. Here comes Boston, Queen, Kansas, Styx, all that stuff. So with these guys today, they might have stuff they love. They might have Garth Brooks, Alan Jackson, George Strait, whatever that is. But with it comes hip-hop, little beat-driven music, a little more popish sound kind of thing. And it's naturally going to find its way into the music. That's what it does. So I think anybody that just says, well, it doesn't sound like the old stuff. Of course it doesn't sound like the old stuff. Like, we didn't sound like the old stuff. But the sincerity's there. And these artists know their history, which is nice. It's very flattering when they know their stuff. And I think that's all you can ask of any new people that's in it, is to be sincere and play all the musics that influence them, put them in one cap, and that's country music.
I agree. Thank you so much. I look forward to seeing you again tonight.
Well, I'll be interested to see what your take on how different it is. It's the music's the same, everything, but the experience is... I stepped up.
Like I said, even the four nights that I saw, the experience was always different, and especially going with other friends. I mean, even my friends who do not like country music were there, and arm in arm, and were singing in every song. I mean, had no voice.
Amen, sister.
I mean, what happened? I went to Garth Brooks every night. Everyone's like, what? I'm like, yeah, don't ask.
Amen. That's the one thing. Okay, is there one complaint about this tour? It's the voice. The voice can't handle it.
Mm. Oh, yeah.
No matter how much. I mean, we did 15 shows in 14 nights in Colorado Run, Sacramento, Portland. And so the voice just goes, and you hate that, but the crowd doesn't seem to mind singing for you. So
yeah.
It's very sweet.
Yeah, agree.